So back to my question about what you bring to it. That was, you got an answer from you. What about you guys? What are you guys going to bring to the table?
Well, for pre-gaming, I am the graphic designer. So most of these pictures that you see up here, I've created so far. The logo, our company logo, characters, a home menu. So a lot of components of the game, I actually create. And also, I thought it would be nice, with some games, there is a review and rate section. So I felt, as a graphic designer, with the players, as they review and rate, I will be able to make the game, make software updates, and make it so that it best fits the player. And even down to when we come up with a second game, a sequel to the game, I will be able to, based off of all of the comments that were given, make the game even bigger and better.
So is there another game in development?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. There will definitely be. We know that Precinct will be popular, so we want our sequel. We want to make it bigger, better. Talk about even more diseases, and we want to end off Precinct with a cliffhanger. So we'll want our players to come back and even introduce even more newer diverse players.
Okay, you said 20,000 annually is what you were charging advertisers. But have you done any research as far as per view? I know like with NASCAR, advertisers are charged for how much time their logo is actually on screen. What happens when you have, let's just say 100,000 players playing, and let's just say in 6 months you double and you've got 200,000. Does that mean that those people are still just paying their $20,000 annually? Twice as many people?
It will increase annually as more popularity grows, so they will be charged more.
Have you figured out how to do a rate or how you're going to do that?
We expect it to go up in about $25,000 increments. So.
And that's based on what?
That's based on how many are viewing the game.
I said that wrong. How did you decide on $25,000?
We decided on that because we wanted to make sure that for every download that we get, we projected sales in about 5 years is about $500,000. So we expect that, including that in-app purchases and the advertisements, that it'll sure happen.
What do you think is safe to say? Maybe you need a little bit more assistance in determining a pricing structure for your ads?
What keeps anybody else from coming out creating this same type of game and just calling it something different? How do we prevent your competitors, companies that are already pretty well established, Play Inc., how do you prevent Play Inc. from just stealing your game? Do you have anything that protects your game from them?
Well, here we do have our patent right here, which talks about the virtual reality component and overall the game.
So you have the virtual reality patented as well as the game patented.
Yes.
And the virtual reality is that you couldn't have patented Google Cardboard.
Not Google Cardboard, but more of like the game the game in virtual reality mode and the game outside of virtual reality mode.
Okay, so the game is patented, protected in both modes.
And also, Google Cardboard has unpatented, they don't have a patent for their design, which means that we are able to use this, but also probably make it better so that we can sell our own pre-gaming virtual reality headsets along with the game. So if there's a viewer like, okay, so I'm having a problem, this part is kind of rough, we can go back in, use the same format, make it better, make it slimmer, make it bigger, whatever needs to be changed, the best fit the player.
And you are planning to do that?
Yes.
At what point in time do you think that option is going to also come out? And how much do you plan to sell for the product? Or sell the product for?
When our app starts to become popular and we see players that say, if a lot of comments start saying the VR is kind of messing with it, we'll start making things that they want in the VR.
Is there a price for the VR?
Right, but how much is the VR headset going to cost when you make it?
Right now, Google Cardboards is about $15, and since this is going to be our own, and mainly based for the game, we thought about raising the price range up to $20 or $25.
You said that you could buy the whole game if you want an ad-free version. How much is that for a download?
That'd be $199.
Okay, and how many different in-game purchases are there, and what do they cost on average?
Well, for in-game purchases, there'll be things such as buying more coins. If you don't feel like earning coins to get another character, buying more characters, other things such as hints for cures, possibly cures themselves, and actually knocking out one of the divisions, which would probably be the biggest one.
Mm-hmm.
So if it's like a really hard level and you don't know how to deal with it, just buy off that level so you don't have to deal with it no more.
For your target market, what is your research about how often, because it seems like your target market is mostly teens, how often are teens actually buying in-app purchases?
Well, we did our market research more on the teenagers our age, so
mm-hmm.
about 84% of African American children use smartphones, 71% of the Latino teen population, and 71% of the Caucasian population use smartphones. So we believe that that gives us a strong market for our app store.
That's true about the market in which the people are going to use it, but what about for the in-app purchases? For that target market, I agree with you that there's people out there who are going to want to do this, but for that target market, how many of those people do you know will actually pay for things within the app?
Well, the price range for the in-app purchases are more reasonable, so we feel that if we make the cost lower but still make a profit off of it, it will still make whatever players that we have want to buy it, because I know typically on in games such as Injustice, if you want to buy a package deal, it's normally about $19. So for ours, probably just buying or unlocking a level will probably not be more than like $1 or 99 cents or even $2.
But you have lots of opportunities.
Yes.
Have you looked at any other companies that run solely off of in-app purchases and seen like what kind of profit they run?
Okay. We have seen companies such as Rovio, the developer of Angry Birds. They use in-app purchases a lot. And they are one of the people who are turning out $230 million in revenue. So.
Okay. With just that game?
They have other games, so they are still making.
Do we know what percentage of that is Angry Birds?
Well, it's mostly the sequels because it's more of a franchise.
Okay. But it is at least a viable model?
They franchise their model?
With Angry Birds, yes. They have different games such as...
They have merchandise, other games, and I believe they even come out with a movie.
If you guys had enough opportunity, would you be willing to franchise, or would you not want to go that route? Would you want to go to a different route?
Well, if we see, I feel like we can all agree, if we see our game gets more popular to the point of like Angry Birds, which was small and got like really big, I think it would be better for the whole business to start doing that, because we'll make even more money, and then we can bring in more fans from all over the world, even like in other places that might not have the game. So then using that, we can put the games in other places where we see a fan base starting to, you know.
Do you think we're ready to make a decision?
Mm-hmm. Who wants to go first?
Who's ready to join pre-gaming in this pre-adventure?
Finally got to say your tagline.
I like it. I like the fact that you, for the most part, have your facts and figures in line, that you've thought about the different areas, and that you've thought about the future. Projected